Hi, today's topic is the ESP32 and switching heavy loads with a solid state relay or SSR. Typically, you find two different types of SSRs, a DC SSR and an AC SSR. And you cannot use the DC SSR for alternate current, and also you don't use the AC SSR for direct current. Because they are based on different technologies, the DC solid state relay are based mostly on MOSFETs, switching MOSFETs, and the AC solid state relay are based on triacs or silicon controlled rectifiers or on bipolar transistors, or also called bipolar junction transistors, BJTs. So please check the label before you use them, and also be aware that switching on live mains currents can be very dangerous or even lethal. So my setup for today: just use a DC solid state relay and an ESP32, and the ESP32 controls one of the GPIOs, and also I use the built-in switch or push button on GPIO 0 for just a trigger event. And after the trigger event, I switch the GPIO pin 13, and the GPIO pin switches the solid state relay on, and so the parallel wired LEDs can lit up by switching the 12 volt supplied by the power supply. And just a small announcement: analoglamp.com sponsors two giveaways, ESP32 module or ESP32 development board. Just follow the instructions in the comments. So let's have a look at the bench. Here we see my setup with the solid state relay and the ESP32. And we can have a closer look to the solid state relays. This is the DC solid state relay. It's rated for 5 to 60 volt output at 25 amperes. And we can use it in an input voltage range from 3 to 32 volts. So we have to be aware that we don't drop below the 3 volt with our ESP32 on the GPIO output. And this is the also compared with the AC solid state relay. We can use it from 24 volts up to 380 volts, and it have also an input from 3 to 32 volts. But as mentioned, if you use this on mains voltage, so it can be very dangerous. And now let's press the GPIO pin 0 button, and as you see, we get flashes on our LEDs. So the solid state relay can even switch very fast, and I try this down to 50 milliseconds pulses, and then the LED stays on for some time. So let's do it again. I press the button, then it's a small delay I've programmed, then the 50 millisecond pulses, then 200 millisecond pulses, then we have a steady LED on, and we can see the current draw is round about 2 ampere. And now a brief look to the source code. This is the main routine. Just we create a task and everything happens in the GPIO task. So let's switch to the GPIO task, and we can have a bigger window. So just some header files that we included. We define our input pin at GPIO pin 0, our output pin at GPIO pin 13. Then we look at our task. The task creates an event group. Just watch my video about event groups. And then we initialize the GPIO pins. So let's have a look at this function. We set our input pin, and we define that we have an interrupt at any edge. Then we set a pull-up resistor and no pull-down. And this is our input pin, and we also define our output pin, and we have no interrupt and just a pull-down. Then we configure our output pin, and we set it to zero, so the output pin is initially low. Then we install the interrupt service routine. Then we set the interrupt handler for our GPIO input pin. And have a look at the interrupt service handler. The interrupt service handler, just if we have a change on the input pin, just set the sense bit. Now back to our GPIO task, we just wait for the sense bit to be set it, and then if it's set it, and then I programmed a small task for our LEDs. So we wait for 2 seconds, then we have 50 millisecond pulses and wait a little bit off time, then we just sleep for 2 seconds, then we have our 200 millisecond pulses, and then we stay on for 5 seconds. And then we clear the bit and the whole routine waits for the next interrupt. I hope you find this useful and you learned something, and maybe you have luck in the giveaway. So thanks for watching today. I wish you a nice day and bye bye.